Today we are going to see how shell sort will work on this array, and plus I am going to write a piece of code for this shell sorting, and also we will discuss the time complexity of this case. So we are going to take this example, and first of all we are going to see how shell sort is different from insertion sort, or you can say what are the advantages of shell sort over insertion sort, right? So let us take this case. If you are going to solve this example with the help of insertion sort, then at some point of time, you will get an array something like this. See, these elements are stored in a 1D array, right? So I am going to write here something like this. See, at some point of time you will get an array something like this. This is sorted array and this one is unsorted array. I hope you know the concept of insertion sort, in which the array is divided into sorted array and unsorted array. We are going to pick an element from unsorted array and we are going to find out the proper place for that element in sorted array, and then we are going to put that element into sorted array, right? Fine. See, now we are going to check for this element from unsorted array. We are going to take this 7 and find out the proper place for the 7 in this array, and this proper place for the 7 is here only. Now for this, for putting the 7 here, how many comparisons and shift operations are required? See, 31 would be shift here, 1 2 3 4 5, right? 5 comparison and shift operations are required, and then 7 would be placed here. So after that the array would be, now after putting 7 here, then now this is sorted array, this is unsorted array. Now we are going to take this 9, and where is the proper place for this 9? Here only, right? And for 9 also, how many comparisons and shift operations? 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5, and after that we will get here 9. Like this, if you are going to place this 2 at its proper place in sorted array, then what is the proper place for this 2? At the beginning of this array, right? And for placing this 2 here, how many, you can say, comparison and shift operations are required? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8. After that, you are going to put this 2 into its proper place in case of insertion sort, right? Now see, if we implement some kind of algorithm in which we are going to compare the element which are distant apart, which are not adjacent. See, in this case, we are going to, in insertion sort, what we are going to do? We are going to compare, see, this is first of all sorted array, this is unsorted. So we are going to compare this 29 first of all, then this is sorted array, then we are going to take this 15. So we are going to take the adjacent element or the next element only, or you can say the near elements only. And because of this property of insertion sort, if a smaller element is at this side of array, at right hand side of the array, fine, and you are going to sort the array in ascending order, then obviously you have to bring that element to leftmost side, right? So because of this property only, this thing to bring the smallest element to the left hand side, this thing takes many shift operations, or you can say many comparison operations, right? Now if we compare, this is our array, and if we compare in first pass at starting only, if we compare suppose this 23 with this 7, let us assume this thing. So at starting only, what we will do, 23 would be compared with this 7. 7 is less than 23. So we are going to swap 7 here. 7 would come here and 23 would go there, right? So see, as you can say, in one swap operation only, at starting only, you got 7 here. But in case of insertion sort, how many operations would be required for the 7 to come here? 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5. Almost 5 shift and comparison operations, right? So what if we implement such kind of thing? We compare distant elements, not the near elements. So this is the main idea of shell sorting. And see, we are going to compare this 23 with this 7. So this is known as, the distance between these two elements is known as, you can say, gap, or you can write interval, fine. So the gap here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So gap here is 5, right? And we are going to compare this 29 with this 9. Gap is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? So in one swap only, this 9 would come at this place, Fine. And in insertion sort, how many operations would be required? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, almost 5 shift operations. And we are going to compare this 15 with this 5, 5 would go here. Then we are going to compare 19 with this 2, and 2 would go here and 19 would go there. That is why you can say that if smaller element is at the rightmost side, then if you apply the shell sorting, then to bring that element to the left hand side, less number of swaps and less number of comparisons are required rather than insertion sort. So now in shell sorting, the main funda is about this gap. How we are going to choose the gap? Gap is 4, gap is 3, gap is 5 or 6, something like this. How we are going to choose this thing? The efficiency of this shell sorting depends on this gap sequence, right? The better the gap sequence, less time would be taken to sort the array. Fine. And there are many methods to calculate this gap sequence, right? See, many passes would be there in shell sort also. So see, it's not like that in every pass gap would be 5. At starting we take if gap is equal to 5 and we are going to reduce this gap till the gap reach to 1. Maybe at first pass you take 3, in second pass you are taking gap, in first pass you have taken 5, in second pass 3 and in third pass you have taken 1, like that. Okay, we are going to reduce the gap, decrement the gap until we reach 1, right? When gap is equal to 1, then shell sort will work same as insertion sort. Now if you will see, if the shell sort will become same as insertion sort, then at starting only we apply insertion sort. But see, the advantage of this thing is that when in the last pass the gap is 1 and it will act as insertion sort, but in that case that shift operation would be very less as compared to this insertion sort, because we have already brought the smaller element from the right hand side to the left hand side in the first pass only, or maybe in the second pass only. So in the last pass very few shift operations would be required. So in this video I am going to take an example in which we are going to take gap is equal to n by 2, where n is the number of elements in the array. This is one method. There are many methods to calculate this gap, and I am not saying that this is the best method to calculate gap, right? Nth sequence is also there to calculate gap sequence. Fine. So we are going to take gap is equal to n by 2 and we are going to take the floor value of this one. Fine. And in next pass, in first pass gap is this one, in next pass again gap would be, let us suppose this is gap 1, in next pass gap 2, and gap 2 would be gap 1 divided by 2, it means n divided by 4. In next pass maybe gap 3 is equal to gap 2 divided by 2, it means n by 8. Like this we are going to reduce till we reach to 1. When gap is 1, then we are going to stop. Then the sorting algorithm will work same as insertion sort. So now I will discuss the working principle of shell sort with the help of this example. Fine. After that I will write down a piece of code for this sorting algorithm. So now first of all find out the gap. Gap could be what? N by 2. I am using that formula. Fine. Now n is what here? 9 elements are there. So 9 by 2 means 4.5. We are taking the floor value. So that is why we are going to take 4. Fine. It means we are going to start from here, and at a gap of 4, which element is there? 1, 2, 3, 4, this one. We are going to compare this 23 with this 31. Then at a gap of 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, this one. Then we are going to compare this with 2, or you can say this is a kind of sublist, 23, 31 and 2. Fine. Like this we are going to compare 29 with 7. At a gap of 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, there is no element. Okay, so we have only two element in a sublist, 29 and 7. Then we are going to compare 15 with 9, 19 with 5. Like this we are going to compare. How actually this comparison would be done when you write down a code, I am going to show you that thing here. So first of all, we are going to compare what? This 23 with this 31. Fine. How we are going to implement this? We are going to take two variables. One is I and one is j. I would be initialized from 0 and j would be initialized from this position 4. See, here gap is 4. So gap and j, both variable would be at same place in starting. Fine. Now compare 23 with this 31. 23 is less than 31. So no swapping would be done. We are going to sort this array in ascending order. Fine. Now, next what would happen? This I would be incremented by 1 and j would also be incremented by 1. Now compare 29 with this 7. 29 is greater than 7, so swapping would be done. Fine. Now after swapping, the array would be something like this. See, 7 is here and 29 would go there. Remaining elements would be as it is. 23 here, 15. So now after swapping, this is the array. See, we are going to swap in the same array only. I am writing in this another array just for the understanding purpose, right? So now this is the updated array. See, I is at this place here and j was at this place, right? Now increment I and increment j. Now I is at this place and j is at this place now. Because see, array in the updated array is this one. So I'm going to consider this array now. 15 is greater than 9, so swapping would be done, right? After swapping, the array would be 9 would come here and 15 would go there. Remaining element would be as it is, right? Now the updated array is this one. See, I is at this place and j is at this place, right? Now increment I and j. I is at this place now and j is at this place now. Now compare 19 is greater than this 5, so swapping would be done. After swapping, array would be, so this is now the updated array after swapping of this 5 and 19. So see, here I is at this place and j is at this place, right? Now after swapping, I would be increased and j would also be increased. Now I is at this place and j is at this place, right? Now see, 31 is greater than 2, so swapping would be done. After swapping, 2 comes here and 31 go there, and remaining element would be as it is. Here is I and here is position of j, right? Now here you have to take care of one more thing. See, we have done swapping, but this is not yet done, right? You are going to compare this one with a previous element which is at a gap of 4. See, previous element which is at a gap of 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, this element. So you are going to compare 2 with this 23. Now 23 is greater than 2, so swapping would be done. Again, swapping would be done. Fine. So now 2 comes here and 23 goes there. Now see, here is I and here is j only. I was here and j at this place, right? Now see, you will see in the previous case, we haven't compared with the previous element after swapping, right? Now why we haven't done this thing? See, let us suppose we are taking this case. When I was at this place, so j was at 1, 2, 3, 4, this place. At some point of time, I and j, right? 19 is greater than 5, so we have done swapping. 5 comes here and 19 goes there. Now, here is I and here is j, right? This is the position. Now find out the previous element which is at a gap of 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. But here is no element because here we have 0th index. So here we have minus 1. So no element is there at a gap of 4. That is why we haven't compared here. But at this case, we have one element which is at a gap of 4. We have one previous element which is at a gap of 4. That is why we are going to compare this with this element. So you have to take care of this thing. In forward direction also at a gap of 4 you are going to compare, fine. And if swapping is done, then again you are going to check in the backward direction also at a gap of 4. If any element exists, then you are going to compare this with this element. If no element exists, then obviously you are going to break the loop, fine. I'll write down the code, then you will get it better, fine. Now see, now j has been reached at this place, n minus 1. Now we are going to stop. This is the stopping condition for this one. This is pass 1. This is pass 1. Now j has been reached at the end. Now again we are going to start pass 2. So in pass 2, gap would be updated. Now gap becomes what? 4 by 2, that is 2. Now gap is 2. Fine. In pass 2. So in pass 2. In pass 2, array is this one. Fine. Now we are going to compare the elements with a gap of 2. Now see, same 2 element would be there. I would be from here and j would be 1 and 2 here. like this we are going to compare. Now at the gap of 2, 1, 2, this element, we are going to compare this with this, then this and then this. And 7 with 5, then 29 and 19. Like this we are going to compare. How we are going to compare, I am going to show you that thing. See, now I is at this place, j is at this place. Gap is 2, j is also at index 2. No, at starting I have told you j and gap would be at the same position. Now compare 2 with this 9. 2 is less than 9, so no swapping would be done. Fine. Simply increment this I and increment this j. Now I is at this place, j is at this place. Now 7 is greater than 5, so you are going to swap. Fine. 5 comes here and 7 goes there. Remaining elements would be as it is. Now the updated array is this one. Fine. See, I is at this place and j is at this place. Fine. I and j. Right. So after swapping, see, find out any element which is at a gap of 4. Previous element 1 or 2. Is there any element? No. So you are not going to compare with the previous element. Move forward. Now I would be incremented and j would also be incremented. Now 9 is less than 23, so no swapping would be done. Simply increment I and j. Here we have I, here we have j. 7 is less than 29, so no swapping would be done. See, if no swapping is there in this case, then no need to compare this element with the previous element which is at a gap of 2, right? If swapping is there, then we check, is there any previous element which is at a gap of 2, or you can say at a gap at in which we are going to working in this pass, then you are going to compare with that element. Fine. Now 7 is less than 29, no swapping would be done. Simply increment I and j. Now 23 is greater than 15, now swapping is done. So 15 comes here and 23 goes there. Remaining element would be as it is. See, I is at this place and j is at this place. Now this is the updated array, but position of I and j is still same. Now we are going to increment this. See, if swapping is done, then we are going to check this element with the previous element which is at a gap of 4, 1 and 2, this element. Now compare 15 with this 9. 9 is less than 15, so obviously no swapping would be done. Fine. So now if no swapping is done, no need to compare with this previous element at a gap of 2, right? So simply now increment I and j. Now I is at this place and j is at this place. Now compare 29 and 19. Yes, 29 is greater than 19, so swapping would be done. So 19 comes here and 29 goes there. See, I is at this place and j is at this place. Now this is the updated array. See, we are going to make all the changes in the same array only. I am just writing another array just for the understanding purpose. So simply increment I and j. No need to do anything. Here is I and here is j. Now 23. 23 is less than 31, so no swapping would be done. Now j has been reached to the end. J has been reached to n minus 1. We are going to increment this j till n minus 1. If j reaches to this position, then we are going to stop. Now this is pass 2. After pass 2, array is this one, right? Now pass 3. Now in pass 3, array is this one. Now again we are going to start. See, in pass 3, gap would be updated. Now gap is what? 2 by 2, that is 1 now. And when gap is 1, this shell sort works same as insertion sort. Fine. Now at a gap of 1, obviously at a gap of 1 means we are going to compare this with this, then this, then this, then this, then this, like this we are going to compare. Fine. Now same process would be done. I would be here and j would be at a gap of 1, that is at this place only. Compare 2 with this 5. 2 is less than 5, no need to do anything. Just increment I and j. I is at this place, j is at this place. 5 is less than 9, no need to do anything. Just increment I and j. I is at this place, j is at this place. 9 is greater than 7. Now swapping would be done. Now after swapping, array would be 7, 9. Remaining elements would be as it is. See, I is at this place and j is at this place. Because this is now the updated array. This is now the updated array. Fine. Now if swapping is done, then we are going to check with the previous element at a gap of 1. Because in this pass, gap is 1. So I is at this place. Now find out element which is at a gap of 1, 1, this element only. Compare this with this, 5. 5 is less than 7, so no swapping is done. Finally, break this loop and increment I and j. Now, I is at this place and j is at this place. 9 is less than 50, no swapping is done. Increment I and j. Here we have I and here we have j. 15 and 19, no swapping is done. Increment I and j. Here is I, here we have j. 19, 20, 23, no swapping is done. Increment both I and j. Here we have I, now here we have j. No swapping would be done. Again increment I and j. 29 and 31, no swapping would be done. Now j has been reached to n minus 1. Now it's done. You are going to stop. Fine. Now see, this is pass 3. Fine. Now if we do again, now gap would be what? What? 1 by 2, that is 0. But the condition would be gap would start from n by 2 till 1. If gap is 0, then we are going to stop. Means this is the stopping condition for this shell sorting. Now you can see this array is now sorted. So see, as you can see, in the last pass, when gap is 1, this shell sorted is working same as insertion sort. But in the last pass, only one swap operation was there for this 9 and 7. Because all the elements are at its proper place. So that is why we follow shell sorting when smaller elements are to the rightmost side. So that we can bring those elements to the left hand side in first pass only. And in last pass, there would be very few swap operations. So now I am going to write down a piece of code for this. Whatever we have done, whatever we have discussed, I am going to write down that thing into code. So now see, we have taken gap sequence as 4, 2 and 1, starting from n by 2 until we reach to 1. So one for loop would be for this gap sequence, one maybe this for this pass, because we have 3 passes, and within this passes we are also having the comparisons. We have taken I variable and j variable, something like this. So 3 loops would be there. So first starting loop would be for gap. So you can say 4, you can say this gap is equal to n by 2, n number of that elements in the array, and gap greater than equal to 1, greater than equal to 1, and then we will write what? Gap divide by 2, because after each pass we are going to divide this gap by 2. So this is one for loop. Now next is what? See, we have taken two variables, I and j. At starting I was this and j was at 4. This is I and this is j, because gap was 4, 1 2 3 4. Fine. So we are going to take this j is equal to gap. Gap value is also 4 and j value is also 4. And we have incremented this j by 1 till this j has been reached to n minus 1. Because here n is what? 9. So here the last index is 8. So what you are going to do? J should be less than n, or you can say less than equal to n minus 1. Fine. And j plus plus. Right? Again, obviously, we are going to increment this I also. Fine, we have to take one for loop again for I. Now, for I. Now, what is the role of this for loop? I am going to tell you. We are not going to assign I is equal to 0. And not, we are not, it's like we are going to increment this I 1, 1, 1, 1 and something like this. Because obviously, I would be incremented till this 4. We are not going to increment I here, here, here and here. Fine. We are going to increment both with this pair. This, first of all, this and this, then this and this, then this and this, then this and this, and then this and this. So I would be incremented till 4, right? So you cannot write that I would be 0 and I plus plus simply. No, you have to do something else. So here I would be this j minus gap, and this I should be greater than equal to 0, and we are going to decrement I is minus gap, or you can say I is equal to I minus gap. So now we are going to check if this value is greater than this value, then it's fine, because we are going to arrange the data in ascending order. Or you can say, in other words, if this value is less than this value, then it's fine. Otherwise, we are going to swap. So you can take either case. I'm going to write here if array name is a of I plus gap. See, I is equal to 0 plus gap. Plus gap means gap is equal to 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. This. So, I'm going to talk about this element. See, this I plus gap is greater than A of I. This element. Then what? It's fine. No need to do any swapping. So, here you will write what? Break. Else, you will do swapping. Else, swap what? This A plus gap with A of I. Now, here we are going to close this 4. Or you can write this coding into a function. You can make a function that is shell sort, void shell sort, and you can pass array and that number of elements in there. And you can write this coding into that function, and you can call that function into main function. So now let us trace out this code with the help of an example. See, I'm going to take the same example. So gap at starting, gap is equal to n by 2, 9 by 2, that is 4.5, integer value we are going to take, that is gap is equal to 4. 4 is greater than equal to 1, yes, so control will go within this loop. Now j is equal to gap is equal to 4. Now 4 is less than 8, n is equal to here 9, sorry. So 4 is less than 9, yes, true. So we are going to enter into this loop. Now I would be assigned I is equal to j minus gap. J is 4 and gap is also 4. So I is equal to 0. So you can say I is equal to here and j is equal to here. This is what we have done. Fine. Now check. A of I plus gap. 0 plus gap. 0 plus 4 means A of 4. A of 4, 31 is greater than A of I, A of 0. Is this greater than? Yes. Then obviously we are not going to swap. Fine. Now, break. Break means, here we find break. Break means the control will go out from the loop in which break is written. So, in which loop break is written? In this for loop. The for loop which is for I. So, control will go from this for loop. From this for loop. It means control will go here J plus plus. So, J is now 5. Right? Now, j is 5, 5 is less than 9, yes, control will go again in this loop. Now, I becomes what? J minus gap, 5 minus 4, that is 1 now. See, now, I is equal to 1. So, I is at this place, right? And j is at this place, j is equal to 5. This is what we have done when we were discussing. Here we have j. Now, find out a of I plus gap. 1 plus 5, that is a of 5, is greater than a of I, A of 1. Is 7 greater than 29? No. So we are going to swap this with this. So we are going to swap 7 with 29. So here we will write 7 and here you will write 29. Fine. Now after swapping, see, we are still in this for loop which is for I. We are not going to do J plus plus. Now control will go to this one, I minus gap. I would be decremented by gap. I is 1, gap is 4. So 1 minus 4, that is I is equal to now minus 3. Is I greater than equal to 0? No. So we are not going to do anything. Why you are going to do this thing? Why you are going to decrement this I? Because see, I have told you, when you are going to do swapping, then again you are going to compare this element with the previous element which is at a gap of 4, because here gap is 4. But here, is there any element which is at a gap of 4? No. So, no need to do any swapping or any comparison. That is why we have taken I should be greater than or equal to 0. Because I started at 0th location. Fine. So, okay, no need to do anything. Now, control will go out from this for loop at J++. J is now 6. Now, I is equal to 6 minus 4, that is 2. Now, 2 is greater than or equal to 0, yes. Now, compare A of 2 plus gap, 2 plus 4, that is 6. See, I is equal to 2, I is at this place now, and J is equal to 6 means J is equal to 6. Now, we are going to compare this with this, fine. Is this 9 greater than 15? Is this 9 greater than 15? No, then you are going to swap. swap, here you will write 9, here you will write 15. After swapping, still we are within this for loop, within this for loop for I. So now I is equal to I minus gap. Now I becomes what? 2 minus 4, that is minus 2. And minus 2 is not greater than or equal to 0, that is why we are not going to do anything. Same thing, why we have done this? Because if swapping is done, we are again going to compare this with its previous element, which is at a gap of 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this element would be at minus 1 and minus 2, minus 2, because at minus 2 we don't have any element, because element is started at from 0th index. So now we are not going to do anything out from this loop. J plus plus, J is now 7. Now J is 7 and I is equal to 7 minus 4, that is 3. Now I is equal to 3. Again compare, 5 is greater than 19, no, then you will do swapping. 5 19, again you will do what? I minus gap. I is equal to 3 minus 4 is minus 1, but we don't have anything at minus 1. This condition is not satisfied, so control will not go within this loop. Out from this loop, J plus plus, J is equal to 8. Now J is at this place 8, and 8 minus 4, I is equal to at 4, I is equal to here. Now compare this and this. Is this 2 I plus gap? I means 4, 4 plus gap 8, 4 plus 4 is 8. So this 2 greater than 31? No. So if not, then else swap these two. Here you will write 2, here you will write 31. Fine. Now I minus gap. Now see, 4 minus 4, that is 0. 0 is greater than or equal to 0? Yes. So again we are going to enter into this loop. Now again check. A of I plus gap. See, I is equal to 0. 0 plus gap, 0 plus 4, that is A of 4 greater than A of I. See, I is equal to 0 means A of 0. So we have done in that case also previous element. We are going to compare this with previous element, which is at a gap of 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we are going to compare this with this. If this 2 greater than 23, no. So we are going to swap. So 2 would come here and 23 would go there, right? Again do I minus gap. Now I becomes 0 minus this 4, that is minus 4, but minus 4 is not greater than 0, so we are not going to do anything. We are going to do now J plus plus. Now J is equal to 9. Is 9 less than 9? N is 9. No. Fine. So we are not going to enter into this loop, out from this loop, and now we are going to do what? Gap divide by 2. Now gap becomes what? 2. And this was the pass 1 we have discussed. So the same process we have discussed without this code, and with this code also we are going to follow the same process, right? So you can trace out this thing, you can trace out this code with the gap of 2, then with the gap of 1. And after gap of 1, you will find out that the array is sorted. So I hope you go to how shell sort works. And the time complexity of this is, in the worst case, it is order of n square. See, I have told you time complexity depends on the gap sequence. I am taking the gap sequence with the help of n by 2. So in this case, time complexity in worst case is order of n square. Maybe if you take better gap sequence and you will get better time complexity. I am not saying that always the time complexity would be n square, order of n square. In this case, if you are going to take this one, then time complexity would be order of n square. Fine. So in this shell sorting, the time complexity depends on the gap sequence you are going to take. So I will see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.